Why is Nordoff Robbins and the work the charity does so special and important?
Well, they do fantastic work with the special needs kids. Their music therapy is, you know, well renowned. I'm sort of familiar with it over the last 20 years or so with Victor and these dinners. And they've been a really amazing sort of charity to assist throughout the years.
Tonight we're getting excited for the Six Nations and also celebrating one of the icons of rugby in Charlie. What makes him for you such a very special player, so deserving of recognition here tonight?
I think, you know, his dedication to the sport. He's a great character throughout the rugby world. Everyone, you know, I know, always says what a great bloke he is. His performances have been fantastic for you know, the teams he's played for. And generally just looking forward to hoping to raise some money for him and the charity, and obviously looking forward to seeing a few old friends and from the rugby fraternity tonight.
Of all the great contests in sport, what do you think makes the Six Nations such a unique experience for fans and for competitors?
Ooh, well, I think probably the closeness of the almost local derby situation, obviously the Six Nations manages to sort of quell up all those historical sort of hatreds against the close foes and allies. But I think, you know, that in itself, the team, it really does, you know, bring out all the real sort of best in the players. Looking forward to watching Scotland play and Ireland and France and all the rest, and see how England are going to be able to perform, because they're going to have a tough time up in Scotland, that's for sure. I think we're lucky to have Ireland at home down at Twickenham. So it's going to be a tough Six Nations for England, because we've had our share of injuries as you will get in the game. But looking forward to see how we're all going to perform, and it should be a fantastic Six Nations, I think, you know.
Talking about getting the best out of the players, what's your assessment of Eddie Jones? Because I think consistency, I mean, you can't fault his record after 2 years.
Absolutely not. Yeah, and I was delighted when I heard he had been you know, employed by Ian Ritchie. So, I mean, it was a fantastic move by him to go and get him and secure his services, because, you know, he immediately made a difference, even without sort of lifting a finger, because, you know, it's really. From my perspective, it was the mental side that he brought to it immediately, as well as obviously the organisation and skills that he's produced. But he was also able to sort of take away the fact that he's not English, and that almost sort of would have been a bit of a backbreaker for a lot of English coaches over the years, simply because I suppose everyone loves to hate England, it seems, you know, as Eddie told all the players, you know, everyone thinks the English are terrible people, and they raise their game to play against us. So he manages to deflect a lot of that in his off-field press conferences, the mind games he plays, and then instill in the players some amazing confidence to allow themselves to go and express themselves on the pitch. I mean, you know, seeing Japan beat South Africa when he was in charge of them, you thought, yeah, well, this guy's got something special, and sure enough, yeah, absolutely he has. So, yeah, absolutely delighted to see him well, and hope it continues for a long time. So,
I guess my final question, obviously you talk about the strength of Scotland, Ireland and England at the moment. Do you think that long accepted Northern and Southern Hemisphere gap has been obliterated now? Because there's a real sense, I think, when you look at some of the results, that maybe that doesn't exist in the way it once did.
Yeah, well, you know, you've got New Zealand potentially still top of the tree. They're still an amazing rugby nation. You've got South Africa have gone down backwards. They're going to take a lot of time to get back up, if they ever will. Australia have been hitting the skids for quite some time. So yeah, I mean, you know, Six Nations, we've sort of tend to get our act together now. The Scotland's have performed outstandingly. You know, the draw with New Zealand and Ireland beating New Zealand in Chicago. And so yeah, I mean, I think we've managed somehow to bring ourselves back up. Even though if you look at the world rankings, I'm not sure we're quite up there. I haven't even looked at it recently, but Certainly, yeah, we've managed to sort of perform and compete with the Southern Hemisphere much better than we have done in the past.